If you have a Chevy Impala, please don't do that to it. Well, that gaudy Impala is gone. Now there's this nice, black, shiny Volvo 240 in its place. Must be somebody who really loves and takes care of it, because it doesn't even have those clouded headlights that are so common on these. And I got something at the thrift store here that I'll show you when I get home. Actually, that intro was recorded when I picked up this Panasonic clock radio. I just forgot to put it in that video, but here's something else I got at the thrift store. It's this PC accessories keyboard with built-in trackball. And as you can hear, it's a clicky keyboard. Nice mechanical key switches. A little bit of an unusual layout in that the arrow keys and things are put up here. Be a little bit better if they put the arrow keys down here and then move the numeric keypad up. Another strange thing is the buttons for the trackball are all the way over here and the trackball is all the way over here. So you need two hands to use the trackball. I don't know why they didn't put the buttons down here so you can just operate it with one hand. I don't know. It would make more sense if this thing was on this side for like a left-handed version. But whatever. It has three buttons, so it should be mouse systems compatible, because I believe the Microsoft mouse standard only uses two buttons. On the bottom, we get flip-out feet with two different heights. We get an XTAT switch, and here's the label. Doesn't really say much about it except model KB20030, made in Thailand. So, taking off a keycap reveals that it uses blue cherry switches, which are pretty widely renowned for their typing feel. Though it doesn't sound too clicky when you have the keycap off of it. And I like this, the label's not even put on straight. So build quality was probably not the highest on this. But let's try it out. Just put this keycap back on. The cable splits off into connectors for a 5-pin AT style keyboard port and a serial port for the mouse. I have my adapter so I can use it with PS2. And here's my price tag, $1.99. Nice coiled cable too, nice thick high quality cable. And the cable got some styrofoam melted onto it, so evidently it was sitting in the box for quite a while. And who knows, this might have been even in the original box when the thrift store got it. They've been known to take stuff out of the box and throw out the box and put just the bare item on the shelf. So, who knows how long it was sitting in that box. I forgot to mention that it came with one of these 9-pin to 25-pin serial port adapters attached. I don't need it, but it's nice to have anyway. And as soon as this laptop gets booted up into Windows, we'll demonstrate the keyboard. I had to change it to disable the built-in AccuPoint, because even though it detected the trackball and the serial port, it was still defaulting to the built-in eraser head mouse. So I had to disable that, and this thing takes forever to reboot, so hopefully it'll finish anytime soon. There you can see the serial port connector for the trackball and the PS2 adapter for the keyboard. Well, I gave up on Windows for now, and it turns out this thing not only supports mouse systems mode, it also defaults to it. Because when I load my mouse driver here, the S switch tells it to go to the serial port, otherwise it'll default to the built-in AccuPoint. It says install the COM1 in mouse systems mode. And then when I unload it and then reload the driver with the Y switch, which tells it to default to the Microsoft mode, says device not found. But there's a trick to get this to work in Microsoft mode. It's the same trick that works for real mouse systems mice, is that you hold down the left mouse button while you're turning on the computer, and then it'll default to Microsoft mode. So I'll do that now, and you'll see that the driver will load in Microsoft mode. So I held down the left mouse button, or trackball button if you will, while turning on the computer, and now when I load the driver, it loads in Microsoft mode. It seems that the trackball is not working. I'm moving it all around, and that mouse pointer, the block in the corner there, is not moving. And if I push harder on this, my finger still not responding, but it does respond to the buttons. For example, if I push the right button, you can see the cursor disappears, and I push the left button and it reappears. I'll open the menu with the keyboard and push the left button and that dismisses the menu. So it is responding to the buttons, but the trackball itself is not working, at least not with this computer. I don't know if it somehow doesn't like the fact that this has a built-in track point thing or what, but I don't know. Either way, it still has a very nice mechanical keyboard, and that does work fine. So, either way, not bad for $2. I'm sure people are wanting to see the inside, and the funny thing is, when I took off the cover, the parts that make up the trackball just totally fell apart here. So you can see the little wheels that make it move. Thankfully, I was able to reassemble it, so now you can see the wheels that go horizontal and vertical to translate the motion of the trackball into the sensors here. And there's this little metal bearing here. So that's how the trackball works. I don't know why it wasn't working, unless maybe bad capacitors or something. And there's the buttons down here, which you could just take off this circuit board and mount it over here and just cut holes in the case, and then it would make a lot more sense to have the buttons over here. So who knows why they decided to put them all the way over here. Well, I unplugged and replugged these connectors a few times to clean up the contacts, but it's still not working. But the cool thing is, if I turn off my camera light here, you can see the infrared sensors that I use to detect the motion of the horizontal and vertical of the trackball as I move it around. So what the trackball does is, when you move it, these wheels have little slots in them that you can see, and that alternately lets the light through and blocks it. And the infrared sensors pick that up, and the pattern of the light that gets through determines the motion of the pointer on the screen, or at least it would if it was working. So these little infrared sensors are at the heart of any non-optical mouse or trackball. Obviously you can't see that with your eyes, but the camera can pick up the infrared. So that is pretty cool to see that on camera. So evidently infrared LEDs are working, but who knows if those sensors are working or if something else is wrong with the circuitry. So that's how a trackball works. And if I turn off the computer, you can see that the LEDs go out. And taking off the cover finally reveals who made this. It's made by Chicony, and it's the model KB5581. Although in this case, it's rebranded as PC Accessories. I had to pull out my trusty old 6x86 computer for another project, which will get its own video eventually. But it gave me another chance to try out this keyboard. I disabled the PS2 port in the BIOS, so it's only functioning through the serial port. And same problem, trackball is not working. The buttons do work, but the trackball is not working. So I think it's safe to say that this is non-functional. But I did find something else by PC Accessories. It's a 3.5-inch disk drive cleaning kit. Brand new in the original package, never used. Still has the liquid in there and everything. It says copyright 1995 PC Accessories, division of Gemini Industries. I don't know if that's the same company that made this PC Accessories, but either way, it's the same name.